Hello, crafty friends. It's Erica, ScrapDiva29. Welcome back to my channel. I am coming on today with a design team project share for the Andy store. If you were watching my channel yesterday, you saw that I uploaded a design team package for the Andy store, and they have a really great release this month. I am showcasing the large heart stitch tags. These ones were the ones that I thought were extra cute, and I knew when I saw these, I wanted to play with them immediately. So that's exactly what I decided to do. So I made a project with these tags. The largest one measures, I have my ruler today. Let's see, this measures 7 7/8 inches in length. And the width is 5.5 inches. And yes, this will fit through a standard die cut machine. But if you have a larger die cut machine, definitely use it because it's a little bit easier to, you know, slant and place at a diagonal to run your cut. But anyway, it's a really great size tag. And then you have this tag right here. And this one measures, let's see, this one measures about 6 1/16 inches in length, so about 6 inches, and then the width is approximately 4 1/4. So that's the size of that one, and then the smallest one measures about 4 3/4 inches in length. So a really nice set of heart stitched tags, and then also there are coordinating pockets that you can also purchase with this tag set, and this is what the pockets look like. There's one for each one, so this is the one for the largest tag, and then there's also the medium size and the smaller one. And what I like about this is that it does come with a layering piece, so that you can layer the front of your tag or your little pocket, and then it also comes with these layering pieces where you can decorate the outside of the pocket as well. So a really cute set. All right, so let's move into my project. Well, actually, you know what? Let me just go through some of the dies that I used in my stash before I get going. I did get in a new die. I got this one in the other day, and this is the extra large bow from Pink and Main. I can move this, but this is the packaging. Pink and Main, I have shared these bows before, and I have every single size now. I think there are 4 sizes to this bow. And I saw on their website the other day that they had an extra large bow. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna get it because I love these bows. And they are super pretty and they're stitched and they're so easy to put together. So I went ahead and picked that up the other day. I did use that in my project. I also used this adorable little banner die, and it looks like this. And this die is from the Alina Craft Store, and it's a stitched heart banner, and I absolutely love it. I think I'm gonna start using it a little bit more, but it's really pretty, and I did use that in my project that I'm gonna show you. And then I did use this die from my stash, this little like medallion. And what else did I use? I used this flower right here, the stitched flower die. It's so pretty, it's a nesting die. I used that, and then I used this set of rectangles right here, and then I also used my Sizzix rosette die. It comes with 3, and I used one of them on the project, I believe. All right, so let's get to my project, which is sitting right here. I decided to make a tag flip, and I have made these before. And I thought, you know what, this is a perfect die to create a tag flip. And this is what it looks like just standing up. It's so cute. Let me just show you what I did on the front. I did use these sequin bows that I picked up off of AliExpress. And then I just took some trim out of my stash. And I think this was from Hobby Lobby, this pink one with the gold trim is from AliExpress, and then I believe these two are probably from Michaels or Hobby Lobby. And I just attached them and tied them on this jump ring, which I did recently get from Ali. And then I attached the bows on both sides of my tag flip. So if you're looking at it this way, you can see one bow on this side, and then if you're looking at it this way, there's another bow on this side, just to make it even. So I did it on both sides. So I just love it, so cute. I'm going to go ahead and just open it up because I think this will be easier for me to share the tags individually. So here is the first tag, and I want to, I forgot to show you something really quickly. The collection that I used is the Rosie Studio collection, and it's called the Let's Get Together. Let me show you right there. And this is the collection that my friend Nurse Tara 04, she had sent me this in Happy Mail the other day, and I knew immediately I was gonna play with it. And she sent me the entire collection, and I used a little bit of everything from this collection, and you'll see in my tag flip. But it's super, super cute, and she actually has her store, and she is selling that collection in her store. So I'll leave that information in the description box below if you wanna check that out. All right, so let's get to the first tag, and I did use the medium tag set on this project. There you see that beautiful pink and maine bow dye. I used the extra large one, and then I also used the, I think this is the large one, and I just layered it with different colored cardstock from the paper collection. And then getting a little bit closer, I did do an acetate shaker, and I just did a fun sequence mix that matched this paper. And I sewed around the acetate so it was see-through, so you could see the sequins, and then the cute little house paper that's behind it. And then I used a lot of the little bits and pieces of ephemera that comes with the collection, and I just layered it, and that's a dimensional sticker. And then the blue and white tag, that's the tag from the Alina Craft store, that little banner. It's so cute. They're tiny little stitched hearts, and I used the large one and the small one in different colors, and I just love, love, love that little banner. It's so cute. So I just layered it up, and it is popped up on foam for dimension. And then on the very bottom, I did add some trim, and this is white trim with the gold on the end, and this was trim that I did pick up off of AliExpress, and I love that trim. It's so pretty. So that is my first tag. And then the second one that I made looks like this, and I think it came out so cute. I love the fun, bright colors in this collection. It just screams like summer, and it's obviously like an outdoor, like barbecue picnic type theme paper, so it's really pretty. But I'll get in a little bit closer. The little llama and life is a picnic. These are all little bits and pieces from that collection. This right here is a wood veneer piece that came with it. And I did use a little jump ring and popped on this little wire wrap bead. And I did buy some from Shara Crane the other day. So I'm using one that she sent, that she made. And then I just layered with the ephemera, and then I made a rosette that's using that Tim Holtz rosette. Hopefully I'm focused. And I think it came out so cute. And again, these flowers are just ephemera. I used some of the puffy stickers that are in that collection. And then there is my pre-made bow. Yes, I popped a pre-made bow on there that I just showed in my last video, or a couple videos, I don't know, a day ago. You guys know, the bow video. This is a vinyl bow, and then I also used a faux leather, so I combined those two, and then I added my little gem in the center, and then this little tag is part of that collection. It came with tags. It literally had like everything in that collection. It's so pretty. I was able to, you know, play with a little bit of everything on here. So that is the second tag, and I love that it's dimensional, and what I plan on doing is when you flip it up, I will be able to stick a photo on the back. So this is gonna be a little photo flip of my family. All right, moving along, here is my next tag. And again, this paper is just so much fun. I used that little medallion die that's in my stash, and I just layered some of the ephemera. It says celebrate life. I even put a little bit of thread. This is a bow die from my stash. And I did double layer this tag. I used the smaller stitch tag and then the larger one on this one. And these are little bits of ephemera from the collection. And there on the bottom is where I used that heart stitched banner again to make my little medallion, and I think it came out so cute. So a lot of fun. And what I did was I did use solid blue cardstock, and then I did die cut it with the yellow cardstock, which came with the collection. And then I just cut the paper on the inside of the stitching so that I could layer it with a different color. So that's how I was able to create the tag, in case you're wondering. Super, super cute. Okay, moving along. So this is the base of my box. And since I didn't have a 12 by 12 paper pad, I had to use some solid cardstock from my stash. And I just decided to take one of the 6x6 papers and just cut it in, like, I think 1-inch strips, or maybe 2, I can't remember. I think it's 1-inch strips. And I just spaced it out so that my base of my flip was just decorated with some of the collection. This is the inside. I just used this pretty blue paper. And then on this side, I did the same thing. And I'll show you once I get to the back of this one. But super, super fun. And my little bow, it does slide off. It's not like glued onto the ring. So I can slide it on and off if I want, or it will move. All right, so the next tag looks like this. And again, I used another Pink and Main bow die. That is the large one. It's so pretty. This die right here is a hexagon die from the Surprise Creation store. And I just layered it with gold foil and then some of the pattern paper. And then I went in with my sewing machine and sewed around some of the ephemera. I used some of the puffy hearts. This is the wood veneer. And then this is just some of the bits and pieces of ephemera that came with the collection. And that's how I layered it. And I did add some trim down here, probably for Michaels. And again, I cut this tag out of some like turquoise or teal colored cardstock, and then went back in with the pattern paper on the inside of the tag. So super pretty. And then on the top, I did layer it with some foil, only because I was working with a 6x6 paper pad, and I didn't have enough to cover the top. So that's why I did that like that. But it worked out, and it came out super pretty. So I love it. So that's that tag. And then the next one, let's see if I'm just gonna have to take this out. So the next one looks like this, and I really love the way that this one came out. This one, I just used a bow die from my stash. I popped a star sticker, one of those puffy star stickers, in the center of this one. Excuse me. And then you can see I used that flower die that's stitched, and I layered it a couple of times, and then I went in with the ephemera. And then I did one of these like little wavy paper flags. I think it was Melissa, the Vintage Goose, shared how to do that. So I did that. And then I created this little embellishment using this is a stitched rectangle die that I used. Then I layered it with the Alina Craft banner, which is in white. And then this is ephemera from the collection. The puffy heart is from the collection. The bling that I use is actually from the Pink and Main store. It's like their clear bubbles, I think it's called. It's so pretty. And I popped it in the centers of the stars. And then I have my little eyelet that's attached to my little rectangle. And then I even have a little tassel dangling, and I have a little heart charm. And these are little items that I have picked up off of AliExpress. And I do want to say that I have been seeing several crafty ladies making these types of embellishments. And I saw a lady on Instagram, and I believe her Instagram is Crafty. Oh my gosh, what is it? Crafty Creations by Anne. I can't remember, but I will link it down below if you want to check out her feed. But I did get inspired by seeing several ladies creating these, and I wanted to give it a try. And then that is it. And it is popped up on a lot of foam dots to give it that dimension, in case you're wondering. And it just makes everything pop when you do that. So super, super cute. Love that tag. And then the last tag that I made looks like this. And this one's just on white solid cardstock. And that paper is super pretty with the pink and gold. Again, I just used all of the little bits of ephemera and stickers with this collection. I used another one of my handmade bows that I just recently shared. I made this rosette. I stuck the best day on top of the rosette. And I just did some layering, so everything is popped up. And that is it. That is my little tag flip. And so basically what I can do is I have this side right here. And again, I did the strips on this side. Oh, I forgot. I did add some eyelets on both sides, on here and on here. And I did pick up those eyelets on AliExpress, but obviously you can get eyelets anywhere. But I did recently get a bag of those white ones from Ali, and they work really good, by the way. And I like the fact that it comes with that little piece that you can put behind the eyelet. It really works really well, and it comes with it. So that is really, really nice. So anyway, this is my tag flip. This video is getting extremely long, but I hope that you guys are inspired. If you want to learn how to create the base of the tag flip for this particular tag that I share today, let me know in the comments and I'll be happy to do a tutorial. It's super easy and fun. Please leave a comment, check the description box below for product information. If you have any questions, let me know. Thank you for stopping by, and I will catch you in my next video. Bye for now.